Happy New Year to all of you. It was on the very edge that he lived. Most of the time, he didn't know on which side of the line his existence was. Was it in the inner circle or was it in the outer circle? Was he rich or was he poor? Was he alive or was he just living? A hair to the left and he was another. A hair to the right, he was another again. It was that close. Everything depended not on millions, as he used to say, but on 1 0, or rather on 1 token, 1 ride uptown or 1 ride downtown. When he sat hungry and low, after a long walk downtown, when there was no money left for a token, he didn't know, was this a monk's test or a punishment? Both ends were equally at his reach. His life was like many arms of Buddha, he used to say. It always seemed to him that it was he who was the real master of his life. It all depended on which arm he moved. A most free man of them all, linking the inside with outside, walking on the very edge of nothingness. Maybe that's what Buddha was all about, he used to say, walking on the very edge of one's existence. But was this edge an abyss or a brim of fullness that he didn't know? And it didn't matter, but he knew, and it mattered to him, that he was walking along that narrow rim, and with every slightest movement of any of his many arms, he could make gestures of desperation and gestures of ecstasy. So he continued his journey, cutting with the very edge of his existence through the Christ's cross, through the Veronica's scarf, through the Buddha's face, and through the very heart of the island of Manhattan.